हेलो हाय एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम बैक टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे टॉपिक इज जेई मेन केमिस्ट्री सिलेबस। सो स्पेशली वी विल टॉक अबाउट व्हाट आर द मेन टॉपिक्स इन केमिस्ट्री सिलेबस। आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ ट्वेल्थ लाइक एमपीएससी स्ट्रीम स्टूडेंट्स दे टेकिंग इन टू एडमिशन इन एनआईटी एंड ट्रिपलआईटीज एंड लाइक टॉप सेंट्रल इंस्टीट्यूशंस एंड प्रीमियर इंस्टीट्यूशंस। सो दे नीड टू क्लियर द जेई मेन्स एग्जाम। So in the part of JEE mains exam today we will see that the brief main syllabus of JEE main chemistry topics. Okay, you can see here I will give you the slide by slide what are the main topics involving in the JEE chemistry syllabus or chemistry papers. You can see the first one. First of all, you try to understood what like JEE mains exam, joint entrance exam. This is nothing but of conducted by the National Testing Agency NTA. This is one of the nowadays all exams are conducted by NTA. This is one of the excellence in assessment also. The joint entrance exam JEE mains formerly you knows the all people the All India Engineering Entrance Exam AIEEE is and the All India standardized computer based test. The admission taking into the various like undergraduate engineering and technical and architecture courses. The exam is conducted by the National Testing Agency. The rank secured in the JEE mains helps the candidate to secure admission in the premier university such as the national institutes like technology like NIT and IIIT, Indian Institute of Information and Technologies, okay, and like top universities SRM University, VIT University, Satyabhama Mount of Dreamwood Universities also and Central Universities also. Nowadays they are offering based on the JEE main entrance exam, are they getting the ranks and scoring also. You can see that first one, the you can look into the paper pattern. You can see that total JEE chemistry syllabus are the three parts, section A, section B and section C. Section A will deal with the physical chemistry, section B is inorganic chemistry and section C is special in organic chemistry. You can see these are the physical chemistry have total 10 units, inorganic chemistry like section B 8 units and organic chemistry having the 8 units. So these topic at least you can keep in your mind. This is called simply like mindset or the mind frame framework. So mind framework also is very important in entrance exam. See here the chemistry section A is we will discuss already previous the physical chemistry. The physical chemistry first one unit is some basic concepts in chemistry. What is the some basic concept of chemistry? If you see that matter and its nature, Dalton's atomic theory, concept of atoms, molecules, elements and compounds. And you can see here the physical quantities and their measurement in chemistry, precision and accuracy, significance like figures, SI units, dimensional analysis, law of chemical combination, atomic and the molecular masses, mole concept, molar masses, percentage composition, empirical molecular formulae, chemical equation and stoichiometry. These are the some basic concept of chemistry in the part of physical chemistry like section A. You can see the second one unit. What is the second one unit? States and matter. So he knows very well the states and matter. So the any matter is classified into three parts, either solid, liquid or gas. You see the gaseous state, measure the properties of gases, gas laws or Boyle's laws, Charles laws, Graham's laws of diffusion, Avogadro laws, Dalton laws and partial pressures. You can look into that liquid state, properties of liquids, vapor pressure, viscosity, surface tension and the effect of temperature on them. Next we will look into that solid state, Bragg's law or the simply Bragg's equation and is the application, packing of solid, FCC, BCC and HCP, lactics. These are the second unit subtopics of states and matter. Now coming to that fourth unit, atomic structure. Atomic structure also this is very important topic and most all competitive exams like JEE, Advance, Mains also they will ask this topic. So Thomson and Rutherford atomic models and their limitations, nature of electromagnetic radiation and photoelectric effect, Bohr's model and of a hydrogen atoms, Heisenberg uncertainty principle, S and P and D orbitals, electron spin or spin quantum numbers. These are the subtopics of the third unit atomic structure. Now we can look into the fourth one unit, chemical bonding and the molecular structure. So you can see the topics, Kausal-Lewis approach to chemical bond formation, ionic bond, covalent bonding, quantum mechanical approach to covalent bonding and molecular orbital theory. You can see that remaining topic like fifth one unit. The fifth unit is chemical thermodynamics. So this is also very important. Fundamental of thermodynamics, system and surrounding, extensive and intensive properties, state functions, types of process. And you can see the first law of thermodynamics, what is the concept, heat internal energy, and what is enthalpy, what is heat capacity, molar heat capacity. The second law of thermodynamics, standard Gibbs energy, changing, and equilibrium. This is the fifth topic. And next we will see solution. Different methods for expressing the concentration of solution, either the molarity, molality, and mole fraction and percentage. And you can see the seventh one unit, equilibrium. Henry laws, ionic equilibrium, equilibrium involving chemical process. This is the subtopics. And next you can look into the eighth one unit, redox reaction and electrochemistry. Eighth one topic is redox reaction and electrochemistry. What is the subunits? Electronic concept of oxidation and reduction, electrolytic and metallic conduction, Kolrosch law and its applications, electrochemical cells like electrolytic and galvanic cells, different types of electrodes. These are the subtopics of eighth units. Next we can look into the ninth one topic, chemical kinetics, rate of chemical reaction, factors of affecting the rate of reaction, Arrhenius theory, activation energy, zero and first order reactions. This comes under the chemical kinetics. Next we'll see the 10th one unit, surface chemistry, adsorption, catalysis, colloidal states. These are the main topics of surface chemistry. Next we'll look into the section B. Section B also is very important. You can see that inorganic chemistry. Inorganic chemistry also is the part in JEE mains and advance also. You can see the first one unit, classification of elements and periodicity in properties. You can see modern periodic law and present form of a periodic table, S, P, D and F block elements, valences and excitation states. Then you can see into that second unit, general principle and process of isolation of metal, how that minerals, ores, extraction of metals, etc. Next we will see the hydrogen, third one unit is hydrogen, position of hydrogen in periodic table, what are the isotopes of hydrogen, preparation, properties and uses of hydrogen, physical and chemical properties of water and heavy water, the structure, preparation and reaction and uses of hydrogen peroxide. This is also very important. Then you will come to that fourth one topic, like fourth one unit, S block elements. Simply you know that already, S block elements mean nothing but of alkaline and alkali earth metals, alkaline and alkaline. The group 1 and group 2 elements comes under the S block elements, general introduction, electronic, configuration and general trends in physical and chemical properties of elements, analogs, properties of first elements, can see this also, like first and second block elements, and first and second group elements, general introduction, electronic configuration, and general trends in physics and chemical properties of elements, analogous properties of first elements of each group, dielectrical relationships and properties of some important compounds, sodium carbonate and sodium hydroxide, sodium hydrogen carbonate, industrial uses of limes and limestones, plaster of Paris, cement, biological significance of sodium, potassium, magnesium and calcium. You can think the fifth one topic is very important. Fifth one topic especially for like P block elements. P block elements mean nothing but of group 13 to group 18 elements comes under the P block elements. Group 13 to 18 elements. So group 13 preparation and properties of fuses of boron, aluminium, borax, boric acid, boron trifluoride, aluminium chloride and alumina. Then we can come to the group 14, allotopes of oxides of carbon, silicon, tetrachloride and silicates. Group 15 means allotropes of phosphorus. Group 16 means allotropes of sulfur. Group 17 means allotropes of interhalogen. Group 18 means about noble gases. These are the P block elements. Okay. Next you can see that unit 16, D and F block elements. Transition elements, inner transition elements, lanthanides and actinides. These are the unit 16. Next we'll see the unit 17, coartation compounds, Werner's series, chelation, isomerism, bonding valency or bond approach, crystal field theory comes under the coartation chemistry compound. Next we'll think about the last one unit, environmental chemistry. Environmental pollution, atmospheric pollution, troposphere pollution and the stratosphere pollution. Stratosphere means immediately we'll think deflation of ozone layer. Next one say water pollution and soil pollution. Okay, and it comes under the next one section is organic chemistry. You can see that section C is the comes under the organic chemistry. Organic chemistry also have sub units. So first one unit is purification and characterization of organic compounds. Purification itself we have the crystallization, sublimation, distillation, differential extraction and chromatography, quantitative analysis and qualitative analysis. Unit 2, some basic principle of organic chemistry. You can see here tetravalency of carbon, hybridization, covalent and fusion, homolytic and heterolytic, free radicals, carbocations, electrophilic and nucleophilic, and resonance and hyperconjugation. These are the some parts of in unit 2. You can think unit 3 is the hydrocarbons, alkanes, conformation, Sahars and Newman projection. Alkenes means geometrical isomers, ozonolysis, Marconi flow. These are the very important. Alkynes, polymerization, hydrogen halides, aromatic hydrocarbons, nitration, halogenation. These are the subtopics of unit 3. Next, we look into the unit 4. Here, number is wrong. Organic compounds containing halogens. Unit 5, like organic compounds containing oxygen, like alcohol, phenols, ethers, aldehyde, ketones, and carboxylic acids. Next, we'll see the unit 24, like unit organic compounds containing nitrogen, amines, diazonium salt, polymers. Next one, biomolecules like carbohydrate, protein, vitamins and nucleic acid. These are that. Next we'll see the chemistry in the everyday life. What are that? Chemistry in medicines, chemistry in food and cleaning agents, soaps, detergent also use. Then principle related to practical chemistry also they will, sometime they will ask you. Okay. And you can see I will introduce one topic. Anything if you who have never made the mistakes, the never tried to anything new. And thank you for watching my video. Like, share, comment and subscribe for more interesting updates. So next video we will go to detailed information about the each one topic and previous bits also. Thank you.